Solomon's hair. He got a souvenir, and the hair is flying. He got a big handful of Solomon's hair. Hello again, everyone, and welcome to World Championship Wrestling here on TBS. I'm Jim Ross, along with Paul E. Dangerously. We will describe the action sold out to the rafters here in Columbus, Georgia, at the Municipal Auditorium. In the program, a special announcement from the WCW Control Center with Gordon Solie pertaining to the World Tag Team Championship. We'll also have some highlights on this past Sunday's Great American Bash. It's going to be an outstanding broadcast. Barry Windham will be here. He'll be taking on Black Bart.
That's right. Barry Windham, who has not made a statement since last Sunday night. I will speak to Barry Windham tonight on WCW.
Plus, ladies and gentlemen, the enforcers Arn Anderson and Larry Zbysko are here in tag team competition.
Now, here is a team that even you have to admire. Larry Zbysko and the enforcer, AA Arn Anderson, have come together. They want a pair of championship belts.
Plus, Nikita Koloff, the Russian Nightmare, the master of the Russian Sickle, will be taking on two men, Paul.
The Russian Nightmare, Nikita Koloff, against two men in a handicap match. Also on this program, the Stinger himself, who also has not talked to the media since last Sunday night. I'm going to go in his dressing room. Hey, I have First Amendment rights. I'm a reporter. I'll speak to Sting tonight.
Plus, fans, we're going to kick it off here today on TBS with the United States Tag Team Championship matchup. It will be the Z-Man and Robert Gibson joining forces for the first time. They'll be taking on the Freebirds right now. Let's go up to our ring announcer, Gary Capetta.
Ladies and gentlemen, this contest on World Championship Wrestling, it is for the WCW United States Tag Team Championship. Introducing team number one, first from Minneapolis, Minnesota, weighing 251 pounds, the Z-Man. His tag team partner, Pensacola, Florida, 234 pounds, Robert Gibson!
Hey, somebody wrote some graffiti on his t-shirt.
I'm sure that he did that himself. These men will challenge for the very coveted United States Tag Team Championship.
And ladies and gentlemen, their opponents. They will be accompanied to the ring by the chairman of the board of the Diamond Exchange, Diamond Dallas Page, along with the road boss, Big Daddy Dink, from Backstreet, USA, in Atlanta, Georgia. They are the United States and World Six-Man Tag Team Champions, the Fabulous Freebirds!
United States Tag Team Championship on the line here momentarily, but wait just a moment. Here come the enforcers, Arn Anderson and Larry Zbysko. What's going on here?
Well, obviously they have something to say.
Cut that garbage off for a minute. I got good news and I got bad news. The good news is you two guys have an opportunity tonight before God and everybody to become the U.S. champions. But the bad news is if you do, you will have the shortest title reign in history. Because as I look at this traveling circus over here, the bearded lady, the human billy goat, and P.S. Hayes, I can only ask you, I see all of this get up and all this leather, but what I don't see a wrestler. I don't see a wrestler among you. If you can look in your manhood, give two real wrestlers a shot at those belts if you prevail tonight.
Well, we've got some problems here, fans.
The way I see it, there ain't nothing but air and opportunity, so let's either get it on or get gone.
Well, we've got some problems here. We got a championship match scheduled. Fans, let's take a commercial break, and then we'll be back with this United States Tag Team Championship. We have problems here at the outset of the broadcast. Let's go to the break, and we'll be right back. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are back, and the bell has sounded. Finally, head of security, Doug Dillinger, and WCW official...
stuck their nose where they shouldn't belong.
Grizzly Smith came out and got the situation taken care of. I've got Anderson and Zbyszko back to the locker room area.
Have I told you lately, it's not our fault?
So it's quite obvious that the enforcers, Anderson and Zbyszko, have championships on their mind, and it will be Robert Gibson starting out against Michael P.S. Hayes in this match for the United States Tag Team Championship here on TBS.
Well, here you see Robert Gibson truly showing what he's all about. He alienated Richard Morton when he got injured, and now he's trying to get yet another tag team title with the Z-Man, who never really succeeded in tag team competition.
The Z-Man at one time was one half of the United States Tag Team Champions. Robert Gibson has been a World Tag Team Champion four different occasions. That gives them the qualification, the background, to be a tremendous threat to the Freebirds, or anybody else for that matter, for any tag team championship.
And since neither man could keep a tag team partner, they run to each other to find, well, I guess misery loves company, doesn't it?
Good hard drag takeover by Robert Gibson. A man that we can say has amassed a tremendous reputation as a tag team wrestler.
But he's amassed that reputation with Richard Morton. Not with the Z-Man, with Richard Morton, who carried the Rock and Roll Express for 10 years.
Well, that's certainly your opinion, and one that would fit in the minority, I would think. Hayes and Gibson, and it's Hayes with the advantage offensively. Irish whip to the center of the rope, but Gibson, nice counter. There's a sunset clip cradle and a near fall situation. And Hayes already making the allegation that his tights were pulled. Tremendous crowd on hand here in Columbus, Georgia. It is jammed to the rafters here, and this is one of the great stops of the Great American Bash Tour that's ongoing now through August 25th.
Tonight, Johnson City, Tennessee, the Great American Bash, where everybody in Tennessee can make up their own mind. Who truly was the dominant member of the Rock and Roll Express? Gibson or Morton?
For the United States Championship!
Big Daddy Dink having to restrain Freebird Michael PSAs from some extracurricular activity with our fans here.
As a matter of fact, if you want to talk about the bashes this weekend, tomorrow in Knoxville, Tennessee, I understand, during the Great American Bash, that the Freebirds have challenged PN News to find himself MC Hammer, another rap partner, and do a battle of the bands. Did you know that?
No, I wasn't aware of that, as the fans here are obviously behind Robert Gibson and the Z-Man.
Well, I've taken a look at some of the fans in attendance tonight, and I wouldn't want them behind me, if you know what I mean.
Tag is made, and the exchange will be made as the Z-Man comes in with an elbow to the tricep of Michael Hayes. Twists that wrist lock, puts the pressure on Hayes.
Very smart game plan by the Z-Man. You want to take away the left arm of Michael P.S. Hayes, because that's where he comes out of nowhere with that devastating left jab.
Fans, we are just kicking off what we think will be a very dynamic two-hour broadcast here today on TBS. Big announcement coming up regarding the World Tag Team Championship situation. Michael Hayes now goes up to the top rope. But the Z-Man caught it coming off. He's going for a pin here. One, two, an inside cradle, and Hayes one count away from losing the United States Tag Team Championship. And once again, Hayes claiming that his tights were pulled. Senior referee Nick Patrick, who heads up this outstanding officiating crew that worked the matches here in WCW, not falling for Hayes' allegations.
You know, I think Nick Patrick did a favor to the Z-Man and Robert Gibson, because if they won the U.S. Tag Team titles, they'd have the enforcers to contend with. And I don't think anybody at this point in time wants to mess with Anderson and Zbyszko.
All right, Jimmy Jim Garvin and Michael Hayes doing a little posing. They're certainly confident of their abilities.
I didn't know that we had a bodybuilding offspring.
And the Z-Man was somewhat of a satirical impersonation of Jimmy Jam Garvin and Michael Hayes. Garvin forcing Z-Man back into the corner. Hammers him with the knees to the ribs and follows it with a right hand. Irish whip is reversed. And Garvin is elevated in that backdrop. Good. Quick, tight, arm drag takeover. And again, the Z-Man mocking the earlier antics of Hayes and Garvin.
The Freebirds need to keep their cool here. Now they have the enforcers on their mind. They know they have a great tag team breathing down their neck in Anderson and Zbyszko, but they must concentrate on the Z-Man and Robert Gibson.
Robert Gibson still has a major score to settle with the York Foundation, specifically Richard Morton, his former tag team partner.
And the Z-Man has a big score to settle with the Diamond Stud. Don't think that's over yet.
Gibson again. The Gibson Z-Man duo using the
There was no tag. Jim, there was no tag.
Well, Paul, you're absolutely correct.
Well, do something about it.
Z-Man and Gibson taking advantage of referee Nick Patrick on this particular occasion. Indeed, there was no tag made.
Then why are the fans saying yes, there was a tag?
Well, they put it back right here. They're supportive of their favorites, which happen to be Gibson and Z-Man.
Each and every week you call me a blatant liar, and tonight you have 10,000 liars surrounding you, but I'm still the biggest liar of them all, right?
You're absolutely correct.
That's not fair.
Again, Nick Patrick talking to Michael Hayes, and again, no tag was made. Z-Man and Gibson pulling a page out of the playbook of the Freebirds here.
Well, thank you for being honest. There was no tag.
Garvin in a very disadvantageous position as Z-Man applies a very snug arm bar. Hope again the broadcast. Gordon Sully has a major announcement in the WCW Control Center. We'll have highlights in the Great American Bash. And Hayes nailed by Robert Gibson. Hayes was standing on the apron and he was tattooed by Gibson. And now the tag has been made. Michael Hayes, who has always been the inspirational leader of the Freebirds, no matter their membership.
Shut your stinking mouth! You shut your stinking mouth!
We hear Garvin referring to the fans here at ringside. These fans taking advantage of the Great American Bash on tour.
Shut your mouth, all right?
They still have the opportunity to join us for the Great American Bash, and I know that the stars of WCW this Tuesday will be heading west.
I'm gonna put you down. Yeah. We don't care.
Gibson maintaining control on Michael Hayes.
Once again, they're trying to take away that left arm. They don't want to get hit with that devastating left jab. Not even Evander Holyfield wants to go jab for jab with Michael P.S. Hayes.
Z-Man using his upper body strength to punish the arm of Michael Hayes.
Hayes needs to get to Big Daddy Dink. Hayes needs to go with another game plan.
Cross body. One, two, and a near fall. Hayes able to kick out, but he's taken right back to the canvas. We're seeing a great illustration of mat wrestling by the Z-Man and Robert Gibson thus far in the contest. Now the U.S. champions making a tag, but again, Z-Man using that arm drag very effectively. And now Garvin with a handful of hair. Does it again and hopes to frustrate him with Z-Man.
Bring it up,
blatant infraction of the rules, and the referee had him break the hold. He broke it just momentarily. But that's all it takes. So many exciting things happened in Baltimore this past Sunday. We'll be showing you some selected highlights from the Great American Bash a little bit later in the program. Dave, that very maniacal, almost Charles Manson-like stare.
As Squeaky Garvin applies the pressure to the Z-Man.
Garvin with a reverse chin lock. Now has advantage offensively in the contest.
Looks to me like the Z-Man is taking a few Z's right here. He could be out.
We're sorry. We're sorry. We're real sorry about this whole thing. We're sorry.
And unlike the Manson family, they're remorseful. They've been rehabilitated.
A modified sleeper by Jimmy Jam Garvin. There's a look at Robert Gibson. And Big Daddy Dink, the road boss at ringside. Nice shoulder block. Football tackles by the Z-Man. Garvin missed the clothesline. Again, the crossbody press. One, two. Z-Man neglected to hook the leg. And he goes right back to the arm drag. And as I mentioned earlier, Z-Man and Robert Gibson wrestling a very smart offensive match thus far.
Oh, most definitely. And it has to throw the Freebirds off because the Z-Man and Robert Gibson have not really gone to the air. Both these men known for their aerial tactics. They have stayed with a solid ground game plan. This has really thrown off Big Daddy Dink and the fabulous Freebirds.
Collar and elbow tie up. Gibson with the advantage momentarily with a headlock. To the other side.
Whoa!
Oh, Garvin pulled down the top rope. And Gibson crashed all the way to the floor. A very timely move by Jimmy Jam Garvin. And to pull down the top rope. And now Garvin will take advantage of the situation. Big Daddy Dink with a clothesline. And he's about a 300-pounder. He's no small manager out there.
No small manager. That is the reason why I retired from managing. Big Daddy Dink, the world's toughest and meanest manager.
Gibson, the legal man in the ring. And Hayes trying to convince Dick Patrick that Gibson went through the ropes. But we saw exactly what happened. He went over the top rope. An assist being chalked up for Jimmy Jam Garvin. And now Garvin doing all he can to keep Gibson at
bay. I'm sorry.
Now you have to forgive him. The guy said he's sorry.
Now that wasn't very heartfelt, I can assure you. Again, a vicious kick to the head by Garvin sends Gibson out to the floor.
Oh, here we go. Forget Tyson Ruddick. Watch that.
There's that left. A thunderous left hand by Freebird Michael P.S. Hayes on the unsuspecting Robert Gibson. And Gibson is going to have a lot of problems if he makes it back into the ring. Snapmare. Now Garvin with the lateral press going for the pin, but Gibson is able to kick out, and now Garvin with a reverse chin lock has the neck, as you can see, crimped on Robert Gibson, restricting the flow of blood to the brain. It can certainly cause unconsciousness. Hayes now has an entirely different expression on his face, one of confidence.
Hear what he said?
Yeah, I heard him.
He'd say they're winning, and guess what? You can't call him a liar because they are.
Robert Gibson trying to come back up to a vertical base and relieve some of the pressure. The Z-Man cheers on his partner Gibson to the ropes. Trying to show some offense, but he's met with a knee to the gut and a right hand to the back of the head. And Garvin and Hayes make another very timely tag. Hayes the cheap shot of the Z-Man. And while the referees are turning the Z-Man, you can see what's transpiring. They're double-teaming Gibson.
Yeah, it was a cheap shot, but it was effective because what Hayes did is he made the Z-Man blow his cool. In comes the Z-Man and the Freebirds got a Dean Gibson.
Come on, Garvin, what's on him?
Hayes using the reverse chin lock. They have used that move very effectively, as have the team of Gibson and Z-Man use the arm drag. Big Daddy D got past the referee, distracted. Double leg pickup. Garvin in pinning predicament, but Gibson didn't have enough left that time to hold him down, and Garvin, the well-placed knee right to the shoulder. Another lateral press, and we had 2.5 that time.
Oh, yeah, Gibson is hurting for certain, and right now everything he does is expending more energy.
Gibson's got him rolled up. He's got him in a cradle, and Garvin had enough strength to kick out. Hayes tagged in, and the Z-Man gets the tag. Z-Man elevates Michael Hayes, catches Garvin with a right hand. Hayes with a rake to the eyes, and now the Freebirds have the opportunity to double team again. Z-Man, a double clothesline. Big Daddy Dink attacking Robert Gibson on the outside. And here comes the Z-Man, and he just nailed the Rotund manager, the road boss, I should say. Z-Man now will soar with the Eagles. Clothesline up the top. Where are the Birds, a new United States Tag Team Champions? There's the Diamond Stud and Diamond Dallas Page. A power slam in the ring by the Z-Man. The Freebirds may be seeing their U.S. tag titles slip away. They're fighting on the outside, but there's the Diamond Stud. He pushes the Z-Man off on his head from the top rope. The referee did not see that action. Garvin dropping the elbow on the Z-Man. But the Diamond Stud was a deciding factor in this one.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners and still United States Tag Team Champions, the Fabulous Freebirds.
Great misfortune.
I'm sorry.
As
sorry. 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 Sorry.
The challengers, the Z-Man and Robert Gibson.
Well, here you see it. Gibson has Michael Hayes in a headlock. Hayes throws him off the rope. Gibson heads full head of steam. Garvin holding down the rope. Beautiful maneuver. Gibson goes out. This causes great injury to his ribs. Now Gibson at a tremendous disadvantage. The Z-Man, after hitting Big Daddy Dink on the top rope, the Diamond Stud shoved him off. The Z-Man lands right on his head. From there, he just lunged me for a Jimmy Jam Garvin, an elbow drop, and it's all academic. 1, 2, 3, and the Birds retain the tag team title.
As we come back, we'll take a special look from Baltimore, the Great American Bash, Pay Per View.
We knew when we got here, they tried to...
Welcome back, everyone, to World Championship Wrestling. As you can see, it is sold out here in Columbus, Georgia for the Great American Bash. The tour is ongoing until August the 25th when it ends in Atlanta's Omni. But this past Sunday in Baltimore, Paul, it was one of the most exciting nights of WCW action that we've ever been around.
Oh, it most certainly was. Hey, there's a brand new World Heavyweight Champion, and his name, well, hey, I don't have to tell him. They can watch the videotape.
Let's go back now, ladies and gentlemen, and take a look at these highlights from this past Sunday night.
Check it out.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following historic confrontation, it is for the WCW World Heavyweight Championship between the top two contenders. Introducing first, the number two contender from Sweetwater, Texas. He weighs 278 pounds, Barry Windham.
He may be number two in your program, but he's number one in the hearts of many fans that are here in the Baltimore Arena.
From Chicago, Illinois, weighing 292 pounds, he currently holds the United States Heavyweight Championship, the Total Package,
Lex Luger.
As these thousands of fans look on, their ovation, quite evident that Luger will be the favorite in this contest. The United States Heavyweight Champion is the number one contender. He's been very active in defending the U.S. title, and he has not had too many opportunities in the last year or so, Tony, to wrestle for the World's Heavyweight Championship.
My goodness.
Kicked him in the face, and down goes Luger. Windham up on top, a big elbow, but nobody there. Windham went for an elbow off the top rope. Remember, he stands 6 feet six. But when he got to the canvas, that's all he found. Luger was gone. Backdrop. Good elevation by Luger. And a clothesline. The big man now opening up on the number two contender in the world, Barry Windham. And coming down the rampway is, that's Harley Race on the right, Mr. Hughes on the left.
What's this all about?
I have no idea. Harley Race, a multiple time world champion. And Mr. Hughes, who is the bodyguard of the York Foundation. Now are they, what's the deal? Are they with Barry Windham? No, Harley Race
is over there talking to Luger.
Won the WCW World's Heavyweight Championship with that Harley Race pile driver, and there's Mr. Hughes. I'm somewhat baffled about their presence. Speaking of Hughes and Race,
you are looking at the new WCW World Heavyweight Champion, the Total Package, Lex Luger.
The Total Package has got a message for the rest of the world.
Exactly right, Harley. A shot heard around the world just moments ago. What we're talking about, there's no frivolity here. What we're talking about is a satisfaction and a job well done, a job long overdue. What we're talking about is the past right here has been forgotten. New history's being made. This is the dawning of a totally new era for the Total Package, Lex Luger. I have arrived. Get used to this face. Get used to this body, because there's nothing like it. The Total Package, Lex Luger, is going to establish a sphere of dominance the sport has never seen. Let this be a message to all wannabe wrestlers, all star wrestlers of now, all has-been wrestlers, because the Total Package, Lex Luger, has finally arrived. There's been an attitude adjustment, so to speak. Barry Windham received an attitude adjustment like any other wrestler who stands in my path. There's a new frame of mind for Lex Luger. The physical tools were always there. I just had to be made to believe in myself, in my abilities, and grab it by the throat. And that's what I did just moments ago.
Putting a man into a frame of mind is the thing that this man liked. It's there now. The Total Package is all together.
Well, Paul, there's no doubt about it. The most coveted prize in all of sports is the WCW World's Heavyweight Championship. The champion will certainly have a long list of challengers coming for him.
Oh, yeah. Now we see why the WCW Top 10 is so important, because look at all the contenders that are now gunning for the brand new heavyweight champion of the world.
One man that wants his chance for the heavyweight championship of the world is the awesome athlete from Florida State University, Ron Simmons. We'll see him next on TBS.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Warner Robins, Georgia, weighing 275 pounds, the All-American, Ron His opponent from Boise, Idaho, 276 pounds, Fred Ivry.
Ron Simmons currently ranked very highly in the top 10, and he had this to say.
You ever wonder why some people would suffer death to get into this country? One reason is because if you get here and work and got the desire to be something, you can be anything you want to be. Wyndham, Luger, you've had your chance at the title. It's Ron Simmons' chance now. I've had some time off to think some things over, and one thing is I know I want to be the best.
But obviously, Ron Simmons has one thing on his mind, and that is to become the next heavyweight champion of the world. And I want to tell you, Paul, this man, Fred Ivry, is a 300-pounder, at least 300 pounds. And Simmons, with that tremendous strength and explosiveness, is just dominating. Drop toehold by Ron Simmons, who has, in recent, the last several days, and since the Great American Bash Tour that began on July the 3rd, I have never seen this man look more intense and any better than we have the last couple of weeks.
And I have found out through my Uncle Moisha, the Peeping Tom, that Ron Simmons is currently ranked number 4 in the WCW top 10. Write it down, you'll see that I'm telling the truth. And hey, he has made a public statement, whether tonight in Johnson City, tomorrow in Knoxville, or Monday night at the Great American Bash in Nashville, Tennessee. He will not be defeated through the Great American Bashes until he gets a chance at the heavyweight championship of the world.
Ron Simmons right now negotiating for a championship matchup. We hope to have an announcement on that next week here on the broadcast. Got Hip Lock Takeover. Former nose tackle of the Florida State Seminoles, who are currently ranked number 1 in preseason. And as Coach Bobby Bowden has said many times, that man was his first franchise athlete. So intense. He knows what it's like to be a world's champion. He was one half of the world tag team champions. But he has only one thing on his mind, and that is to be the next world's heavyweight champion. I'll tell you something. I know he's training hard. He's doing road work. He's doing everything physically possible to get himself in the greatest shape of his life. We know his mind is right, and he's getting his body in great shape, as you can easily see.
Oh, most definitely. I mean, just look how awesome Simmons looks. And this is not like Arnold Schwarzenegger or Lou Ferrigno. His muscles are not there to look pretty. He's there for power. He's there for strength. He's there to beat people up.
Simmons working on the arm of big Fred Ivry. I don't think it makes any difference how big you are. Ron Simmons has the raw power and strength to manhandle anybody he gets in the ring with. Great crowd on hand, and again, you can be a part of the Great American Bash. Ongoing, our final bash will be on Sunday, August the 25th. And we're so happy that the fans here in Columbus, Georgia could join us, and they are here in droves.
Hold on, I got a phone call here. Tell me about that hotline of yours. What did you say this week that's so controversial? Yeah.
Ivry with the elbow. Ivry's a big man. Here to make a name for himself at WCW, but Simmons back on the attack. Big Ron. Let's do it. Boy, what impact. You could hear that one. The smack of flesh, and Simmons has won it.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner, the All-American, Ron Simmons.
I just got the phone call that Barry Windham is indeed in the building right now. I'm going in the back. I'm going to corner Windham and find out his thoughts on Sunday night.
All right, Paulie, we'll go and hopefully speak to Barry Windham. And there you see the impact. Ron Simmons has one thing on his mind, and that is to be the heavyweight champion of the world. He is currently ranked higher than he has ever been in his career. And right now, let's do take a look at this week's WCW Top 10.
This is the current World Championship Wrestling Top 10 as compiled by promoters and members of the WCW Board of Directors. The number 10 spot, the former World Television Champion, Beautiful Bobby. Preceding him, the number 9 man from Macon, Johnny D. Band. The number 8 man, the big man from Halstead Street in Chicago, One Man Gang. The number 7 man this week, the Diamond Stud. Number 6, the World Television Champion, Stunning Steve Austin from Hollywood, California. The number 5 man, 7'7" El Gigante. preceded by the number four man, former All-American Ron Simmons. Number three man, Sting, the former world champion, is preceded by number two, the Russian Nightmare, Nikita Koloff, and the number one contender from Sweetwater, Texas, in at 275 pounds, Barry Windham, and the WCW World Champion, the Total Package, Lex Luger, from Chicago. That's a look at the WCW Top 10 for this week.
Gentlemen, the following tag team event, it is set for one fall. Introducing team number one, first from Minnesota, Arn Anderson. From Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, the living legend, Larry Zbysko, collectively known as the Enforcers. And their opponents, total combined weight, 473 pounds, Montgomery, Alabama, Johnny Rich. From Rock City, USA, Scott Allen.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are back here on WCW. There is a look at Arn Anderson. He and Larry Zbysko, the enforcers, and while Paulie Dangerously's back in the locker room area, setting up to hopefully speak to Barry Windham, I've been joined here at ringside by the man that the chairman of the Diamond Exchange, Diamond Dallas Page. And Dallas, you had somewhat of an altercation earlier here today with the two men we see in the ring, or I should say Anderson and Zbysko.
I'll tell you what, JR, first of all, I don't know where that's coming from. I mean, Double A, he knows I do all the negotiation for the Fabulous Freebirds. He wanted to come out there to try to embarrass them into that. I have a lot of respect for Arn Anderson and Larry Zbysko both. They are definitely enforcers, but I don't see where they come out there trying to confront my boys in the ring when I do all the negotiations.
One thing that we know for sure, that Anderson and Zbysko are masters of the mental aspect of professional wrestling. They're very good at intimidating and planting that subliminal thought that they are here. They are here for championships. And I think basically they got their message across, obviously. As we see Johnny Rich, who's an outstanding competitor. I've always been impressed with his abilities. And another quick tag from Zbysko with Anderson. One thing, you're sitting here at ringside, you're going to be able to see, maybe get some information together for a scouting report, because apparently they want to wrestle the Birds for the U.S. tag title.
Well, it's obvious. They're the champions. And I see how Double A is teamed up here with Zbysko. A very smart move by him. Both of them seasoned veterans, and they look great in the ring. But this intimidation factor has gotten me highly irritated. They should have taken it through the channels. They're way out of line here. And they're not going to be intimidating Michael P.S. Hayes, Big Daddy Dink, or Jimmy Jam Garvin. I promise you that.
Anderson now working on the back of Scott Allen here, burying the knee right to the spine of Allen. And another quick tag. Anderson and Zbysko have wrestled this match basically in their half of the ring. And indeed, that is classic tag team strategy. Again, the body slam, their focal point would seem to be the back. A neck break, putting pressure on the spine and the neck this time.
You can bet one thing, JR, I'll be filming these guys' matches in entirety, and I'll know them inside and out if a match ever does come about with the Fabulous Freebirds.
Well, let me ask you this question. If they do go through the proper channels, as you say, if that man and his partner, Larry Zbysko, come to you the proper way, as you have put it, will you sign a match with the Freebirds and these men?
If they show a little respect, I'll heavily consider it. There's a lot of...
Went for a fall there, and Zbysko, they've worked on the back.
There's a lot of people after the Fabulous Freebirds, and only one person controls their destiny, Diamond Dallas Page.
Anderson viciously bringing Allen outside and ramming his back into the edge of the ring. And Allen's back, his lower back, becoming very discolored from the blows that Anderson and Zbysko have delivered. Zbysko throwing Allen back into the ring. I don't think Zbysko and Anderson have been on the other side of the ring, but maybe one time this entire match. A camel clutch-like maneuver. Putting tremendous pressure on the spine.
Well, you know what, JR? The bottom line with these two guys, they don't need to wrestle a lot together to be great together. They know all the aspects of professional wrestling. And right here in World Championship Wrestling, I'd say they're heck of a tag team, but not as good as the Fabulous Freebirds.
Well, it certainly would be a match that I would love to be in attendance if it's signed. Certainly if. Keep our eye on that negotiation. Yes, if. Big if, perhaps. Zbyszko standing vertical suplex again. The focal point is the back. They are dissecting this kid. And his back, I don't know if you can see it at home on television, but from our vantage point now, an abdominal stretch. They are very focused. I think we both have to agree that this is a tremendous wrestling team.
I'm not going to take that away. I'm just really irritated about this. The more I think about it, JR, the more irritated I'm getting.
We see Dennis Brent at ringside, the editor of WCW Magazine, that will be on the national newsstands in a couple of weeks on August the 6th. Johnny Rich would love to make the tag, and indeed, he certainly needs to, but Anderson and Zbyszko know that as well, and they aren't allowing that. Backdrop, and this young kid, Scotty Allen.
You know, see, this is not Michael P.S. Hayes or Jimmy Jam Garvin in the ring either, JR.
Well, that's a very good point. Even though Allen and Johnny Rich try to make a competitive team, they are not the United States Tag Team Champions. But look at this team, stomping again on the back. They know exactly what they want to do. They have one thing on their mind out here, and they are executing a great game plan as Arn Anderson leers down at Diamond Dallas Page.
Is this in his corner?
Yeah, it is, as a matter of fact. I hope we don't have any more problems. Here at all, a little uneasy about this situation. Anderson now back on his other side, other corner there, as Zbyszko again slams Allen. A lot of great wrestling teams in WCW, and there's the Boston Crab, one of the most basic yet sadistic and effective moves in the sport. A submission maneuver.
You know, at any point, JR, these guys could have beat him, and I can't believe that they're punishing this kid like this.
I think they are here to perhaps send a message loud and clear to anyone with a championship belt. And with you sitting here at ringside, they're giving you a first-hand look at what they would like to do, obviously, to the Freebirds.
Well, let me tell you something.
Oh, there's a spine buster. Ooh, and ahs come from the crowd here.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the match, Double A. Arn Anderson, the living legend Larry Zbyszko, the Enforcers.
Well, Nyman, we'll keep our eye on the contract signing. Keep us abreast of the negotiation. I want to thank Diamond Dallas Page for joining us. There you see the standing vertical suplex. Larry Zbyszko and Arn Anderson dissecting Scott Allen, working on the back brutally. They want a championship. They are impatient. And with moves like this, never discount the athletic abilities of the Enforcers. Fans, when we come back, we hope to have an interview with Barry Windham, as he will be talking to Paul E. Dangerously, hopefully, when we come back. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to TBS and World Championship Wrestling. I think Paul E. Dangerously is ready now and standing by with Barry Windham.
We're back here on TBS. This is Paul E. Dangerously in the back with Barry Windham. And, sir, obviously nothing settled at the Great American Bash.
What do you mean nothing was settled? I'll tell you what. When you get a chance at the World Heavyweight Championship, you go in there all out. And it really doesn't matter what the final outcome is, because you've had your chance at the World Heavyweight Championship, and if you didn't give your best, you shouldn't have been there to begin with. Now, Lex Luger, the times that I've spent in the ring with you have been some of the most memorable and some of the toughest. But the World Heavyweight Championship at stake should have been one-on-one competition. Should have been you and me. But I tell you what, I'll never turn my back on you again. Because of the things that you're capable of, The things that I'm capable of should have never figured into the game plan. Should have been you and me. And next time we step into the ring, the World Heavyweight Championship being at stake, you can be prepared for one of the toughest losses of your career. Because I don't walk away from anything easily, Luger. And I'm going to walk out here in the ring right now and show everybody out there the way I feel about you and the World Heavyweight Championship. So just remember, you'll never see my backside again. You'll never see me walking away from you, because I know exactly what you're capable of, and I know where your head's at, pal.
Well, Barry Windham heading out to the ring right now. If Barry Windham's heading out to the ring, I think it's a good idea for you and me. And Jim Ross, for this one, you're on your own.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first in the ring, he weighs 301 pounds, Desperado Black Bart. And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent from Sweetwater, Texas, weighing 278 pounds, Barry Windham.
Barry Windham, one of the greatest athletes ever to grace the squared circle. Stepping in the ring here against a big man, Desperado Black Bart. As you heard Gary Capetta say, Bart weighed in at 301. And that man, Barry Windham, 6'6", 278. Involved in one of the most controversial and exciting matches that I've ever had the privilege of witnessing in Baltimore. And Black Bart, who hasn't even taken his hat off yet, hammering away at Barry Windham. Windham, as you saw, ladies and gentlemen, ranked number one in the world. Kick to the midsection. Windham, a phenomenal athlete. There's no doubt about it. Great strength and leverage, picking up Black Bart. Remember, he's over 300 pounds. But Black Bart, the veteran, moves out of the way. Wow. A lot of impact there. Another right hand by Windham puts big Black Bart down. Want to say hello to our fans on the West Coast. Great American Bash will be in the Great Western Forum this Tuesday night. Great drop kick by Windham. Another kick right to the head. Right hand. Windham coming with a heavy artillery on Black Bart. Modified DDT by a man that has to be considered right now at the top of his game. And a sleeper by Desperado Black Bart. We haven't seen the big man use that move before. And Windham counters with a sleeper of his own. As we mentioned in the Great Western Forum Tuesday night, San Diego Wednesday, San Bernardino Thursday, and in the Oakland Coliseum Friday night, the Great American Bash on tour as Windham is rammed viciously into the top turnbuckle by Black Bart. Bart needs a victory here to crack the top 10 in the WCW rankings. Very authoritative clothesline by the big man from Pecos, Texas in this battle of the Texans. Windham went up and over. May have hurt his knee there, caught in the ropes. And Windham's in the ropes now. Black Bart trying to choke and hold him down. Windham raked the eyes. Windham may have twisted his knee right there. I'm not real sure. Catching it in the ropes on that backdrop. Black Bart reverses the Irish whip, but Windham caught him coming off with the elbow. And the talented youngster from Sweetwater, Texas, who indeed is a very controversial figure. But the fans here are showing their support for Windham. They know what he has endured within the last week. Windham to the outside. And the lariat takes a big 301-pounder down. Well, obviously, when you talk about the heavyweight championship of the world, you have to talk about that man, Barry Windham. And I'm sure tomorrow night on AM 750 WSB, many of the listeners to our radio program will have their comments about the Great American Bash as Black Bart, who knows full well that a victory over Windham would catapult Black Bart into the top 10 rankings. And Black Bart taking every opportunity to pound and hammer away at Windham. He brings Windham back in with a lot of force as Windham landed in the center of the ring. Desperado Black Bart with the Irish whip, trying to clothesline. And Windham caught him with a lariat. Barry Windham caught Black Bart with a lariat, and that will be it.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, Barry Windham!
As we said, when you talk about the heavyweight championship of the world, you've got to talk about Barry Windham with a very hard-fought victory over Desperado Black Bart. Windham with that lariat, tremendous velocity. Fans still to come here today on TBS. The big announcement regarding the Steiners World Tag Team Championship. And when we come back, a special look at the one-man game.
The following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, accompanied by Kevin Sullivan, who says this is the true giant of WCW. From Halstead Street, Chicago, Illinois, weighing 412 pounds, the One Man Gang. His opponent from Baltimore, Maryland, 224 pounds, jumping Joey Maddox.
Welcome back, everyone, to TBS here today on World Championship Wrestling. Paulie Dangerously has joined us back here at ringside, and I guess the valedictorian of Charles Manson High School, the one-man gang, who is one of the most deranged individuals I've ever been around, has a date with destiny, perhaps, in the Omni on August 25th, when he will put his hair on the line in a match billed as Argentina versus Hair. If the one-man gang wins the match against the Elegante, Elegante will return to Argentina, never to wrestle again in WCW. Well, if Elegante beats the one-man gang in the Omni on August 25th, then the gang's head will be shaved.
Yeah, the gang's head is going to be shaved, but it's going to be shaved by Elegante, and Elegante is not a qualified barber like the one-man gang is.
Well, that's certainly a debatable point.
Well, I'm debating it with you.
Well, that guy didn't go to... What do you think, he went to Floyd Lawson's Barber College in Mayberry or something? He doesn't know how to cut hair. And Sullivan, he's off his rocker to begin with.
As a matter of fact, I happen to know personally that the one-man gang went to the Hannibal Lecter School of Barbering and Kevin Sullivan paid his tuition.
One-man gang, 412 pounds or thereabouts. I guess that could be an estimate. 6'8", 6'9", 6'10", something along that line.
And he's big. He's big. He's big. He's bigger than big. He's the true giant in World Championship Wrestling.
Well, the very demeaning situation that occurred with Elegante on this broadcast several weeks ago has certainly not been forgotten.
Oh!
By the 7'7", 454-pound giant from Argentina, the biggest man in professional sports today. Elegante has a very good memory.
Well, he better have a very good memory, because you need to remember that this man takes his orders from Kevin Sullivan, who gets advice from the Lady of the Third Eye.
Well, I'm going to be talking to Kevin Sullivan a little bit later in the broadcast about their August 25th date in the Omni. Nice haircut.
The gang cut his hair, too.
I can believe that.
Did you know that Igante also knew a lady of the third eye? But it turned out to be just some chick in Argentina who had a big pimple in the middle of her forehead.
Right. I'm sure that's factual.
Are you calling me a liar?
Well, that's been proven so many times it doesn't bear repeating. The gang hammering away at a game cut out in man, Joey Maggs. If you decide to go on a bruise cruise, fans, I hope that you're not on the same deck with the one-man gang and Kevin Sullivan.
Did you know that this Tuesday in Los Angeles at the Great Western Forum, Kevin Sullivan's going to have a meeting with Jack Nicholson and discuss, hey, who really blew over the cuckoo's nest?
We look forward to being in the Great Western Forum Tuesday night. Maybe Jack will be there. Who knows?
Oh, I'm such a comedic genius.
Unique form of communication.
Kind of sounded like your show last Sunday on AM 750 WSB.
Both those guys need therapy, I can assure you. Joey Maggs trying to fight back. You've got to hand it to Joey Maggs, but just have the guts to sign a contract with this big human being, the master of the 747. And now Sullivan telling the one-man gang to fly. And here it comes.
Wow!
747 breaking apart the insides of Joey Maggs.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner, the one-man gang.
Well, he's gone for another one. Another 747.
And it's time for a haircut now.
Oh, come on, guys. What's the meaning of this? There is absolutely no reason for this. This kid doesn't need a haircut.
Yes, he looks like Paul McCartney with that dude.
Look at the gang cutting hair. What a repulsive situation.
It certainly is. It should have cut more off.
And I'm going to talk to these guys.
A little bit off the sides for you. Maybe a little bit off the top. You'd look a lot better if you got a haircut from the one-man gang and Kevin Sullivan. Here you see it, the man that's gonna send Elegante back to Argentina, the one-man gang with a 747. And now, speaking to the gang and Kevin Sullivan, a guy that does need a haircut, Jim Ross.
Well, I'm somewhat uneasy here at ringside during the Great American Bash, but we do know that the final bash will be in Atlanta's Omni on August the 25th. A match has been signed. It's Argentina versus the Hair. If the one-man gang can defeat Elegante in the Omni on the 25th, Elegante returns to Argentina. But if the largest athlete in the world wins the match, he gets his head shaved, Kevin Sullivan.
Don't look so smug to me and all these people here. Just because he's 7'7", 450 pounds, does not make him the giant of World Championship Wrestling. This is the true giant, because I know about Argentina. We just went to Casa de Agua, and we met with the Lady of the Third Eye, and as the gang and her bathed in the river, she told me this. She said, the giant won't be flying home first class. The giant won't even be flying home coach. What the giant is going to be doing is flying back to Argentina in a cargo plane made from the tree that the one-man gang will gnaw down. And we're going to build you a big pine box. You're going back to Argentina. And in the Omni, let's be real clear. It's you and the true giant of World Championship Wrestling. Long may reign the one-man gang.
Ah! All right, fans, I hope that's over. Fans, we'll be back with Gordon Solie right after this.
Welcome to World Championship Wrestling Control Center. I'm Gordon Solie, and of course, the minds of everyone today are concentrating on one thing, and that, of course, is the World Tag Team Championship and the fact that Scott Steiner has been injured and is unable to compete. Well, at a recent meeting of the Board of Directors of World Championship Wrestling, it was determined, according to the bylaws of World Championship Wrestling, that the Steiners must indeed be stripped of their titles. I've been inundated with cards and letters from people saying that they're extremely unhappy over the fact that I had suggested that the hardliners were correct in their assumption that the Steiners would be stripped. Let me now go to the bylaws of World Championship Wrestling and read you the actual rule that covers the World Tag Team Championship and any single championship as well. Rule 2, Article 1, Section 1 states, quote, any World Championship Wrestling sanctioned championship must be defended by the champion or champions a minimum of one time every 30 days. Failure to comply will result in the championship being declared vacant. Well, it has been declared vacant, and now, of course, a tournament will be held to determine the new tag team champions. And this is not to say that we don't have great compassion for the Steiners, because certainly I do. In fact, the matter is, for the next few moments, you're going to be seeing the address and a special tribute to the Steiner brothers. Certainly hope that you will write to the Steiner brothers and wish them well, and I wish them well as well. Now then, another major feud here in World Championship Wrestling, that of the one-man gang in El Gigante. In a moment, we're going to take a look at a situation that occurred first to the Argentinian giant El Gigante, and then one-man gang and Kevin Sullivan. May I just point out, too, the two will meet in the final bash, August 25th, in Atlanta at the Omni, Argentina versus the one-man gang's hair.
He's 420, and there's a 747. Wow. Oh, my gosh. Caving in the ribs of El Gigante.
And they're going to do it to him again.
The gang, well over 400 pounds. Another one. Right at the back, they're trying to break the giant's back. And now they're on top of him. Sullivan is cutting his hair. Sullivan is shaving the giant's hair. Oh, how terrible.
He's no Simpson, remember?
And wait a minute. There comes a barber himself.
Ah, what is that?
He's got some scissors and a straight razor in his hand.
Turn around, Kevin! Turn around!
Oh, the giant hand of El Gigante. He's got those scissors. He's cutting some of Sullivan's hair. He got a souvenir, and the hair is flying. He got a big handful of Sullivan's hair.
In this match at the Omni, then, on August 25th in Atlanta, Georgia, if El Gigante loses, he must leave World Championship Wrestling and return to his native land of Argentina. If he wins, however, then he gets the privilege and the pleasure of shaving the head of the one-man gang. Now, I might just point up also that the World Tag Team Title Tournament will begin next Saturday here on the World Championship Wrestling. We certainly hope that you will be viewing. And now, a couple of final words regarding the Steiner brothers. A lot of people have thought I was a bit hard-hearted when I said no, indeed, they should be stripped of the title. The Steiner brothers are great athletes, great sportsmen, but they're also businessmen, and they realize the importance of the World Tag Team Championship, and they, for one, are not happy about being stripped from their titles, but they also realize that those titles had to be taken from them because they could not defend them. That's World Championship Wrestling Control Center for this week.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest on TBS, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, the godfather of World Championship Wrestling, Theodore R. Long, proudly presents from Macon, Georgia, weighing 251 pounds, Johnny. His opponent from Knoxville, Tennessee, 231 pounds, Larry Santo.
All right, fans, before this one gets underway, let's hear these comments from Johnny B. Bad.
Now, I don't have a whole lot of time to waste out here talking about a no happening, nothing going on PN News. Now, the beautiful Johnny B. Bass got something he wants to say. Tell him, Johnny, baby.
PN News, you big old ugly bear. I am the fashion statement in World Championship Wrestling. Everyone wants to look like Johnny B. Bass. Ain't that right, Terry?
Oh, hey, Johnny.
Fans, we are excited about the World Tag Team Tournament that you'll be able to participate in by joining us here next Saturday on World Championship Wrestling. That's unfortunate for the Steiners that they've been stripped of the titles.
Oh.
It was a book rule. WCW really didn't have any latitude in the situation.
Well, they should have defended the title.
Well, you know the Scott is unable to do that, Paul.
But next week, real bad for him.
Next week it will be the Hardliners beating the Freebirds in the first match of the World Tag Team Title Tournament, exclusively here on TBS.
And what a fight that's going to be. The Masters of the Dirty Tactics, the Fabulous Freebirds against the men that put Scott Steiner out of action, Slater and Murdoch, the Hardliners.
Are you still going to try to talk to Sting in the broadcast?
I am waiting for the phone call. The moment Sting enters this arena tonight in front of 10,000 fans, I'm going to run back and I'm going to get the Stinger himself to talk to me.
Johnny B. Badd, who has really been on a tear recently. Great one-loss record, good waistlock takedown.
Ooh!
And a slap to the face of Larry Santo. We have documented Johnny B. Badd's prowess as an amateur boxer.
Larry Santo doesn't want to mix it up with Johnny B. Badd. He'll go down faster than Don Mattingly's batting average.
The flamboyant one from Macon, Georgia. Certainly is a fashion plate. Really has his, really keeps his focus on his accessories. His earring, his armbands, very color coordinated.
Hey, he's a fashion statement. What? Hold on.
What?
I got another phone call. Better not be your girlfriend again. I'm tired of her. Yeah.
Nice move there by Johnny B. Badd, taking Santo down. Obviously, Johnny B. Badd in control here. Could have pinned him right there, one would think. Johnny B. Badd. Choice words for the big ugly bear, as he calls him, PN News.
Now you get up and fight. Well, I got a big scoop for you. The Stinger is in the arena right now. He's headed to the media room. And guess who's going to land him for an interview? Exercising his First Amendment rights. The greatest asset to wrestling journalism in this
Larry
decade.
Santo going for a pin here.
You interrupted me.
Well, if you want to quit talking about yourself, go do your interview. I don't just, if you want to go, okay?
Can you handle it without me?
I'll do my very best.
Are you sure? Well, fine. Since you feel that way, I'm going to go find the Stinger.
Irish whip and a drop kick by Johnny B. Badd. As Lips dangerously leaves to go. There you see him running by. We'll get his exclusive interview with Sting. Boy, nothing was settled at the Great American Bash as far as Sting and Nikita Koloff were concerned. And this man, Johnny B. Badd, who has amassed a phenomenal one-loss record in the last few weeks. He has been red hot during the Great American Bash. Johnny B. Badd, short right hand there, but his left is where he packs the dynamite. That left hook is really something. Man still to come here today on TBS. Nikita Koloff wrestling two men, and there's a great power slam by Johnny B. Badd. Theodore R. Long saying warm up a little bit, and Johnny B. Badd doing some shadow boxing.
You check this out,
baby. You check this out. He's got great hands. You got to hand him that. He is rather unique. High knee. Right in the chest. Santo doesn't have a prayer from this at this point. And Johnny B. Badd, that left hook. Everyone that has been subjected to the left hook has been out for the three count.
The winner of the match, Johnny B. Badd.
Well, he may be the most fashionable man in WCW, but he's also got a devastating left hook, and as they have called it, it's the kiss of death.
Give him that kiss, Johnny.
Johnny B. Badd and Theodore Long basking in their success here today on TBS, and we'll take another look. Johnny B. Badd, currently ranked number 9 in the WCW World Rankings. Tremendous power slam, but this is his meal ticket. His left hand, boom, right there. Johnny B. Badd with another victory. And fans, when we come back, we'll see Nikita Koloff for sure against two men, and hopefully Paul Lee will be talking to Sting.
Back here on TBS. This is Paul E. Dangerously in the back with the Stinger himself. And sir, it's one thing for a feud not to be settled at the Great American Bash, but this whole situation with Nikita Koloff is raging hotter than ever.
You're right about that. I wake up in the morning and I have that name Nikita on my mind. I wake up in the middle of the night and I have that name Nikita on my mind. I go to the gym, I grab a workout, I got that name, Nikita, on my mind. I walk through airports, I walk through the hotels, I walk into the arenas, and I got Nikita, 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 blistering through my mind, isn't it obvious? There's only one thing on my mind these days, Nikita!
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, a special handicap match. Introducing first, soon to be making his way toward the ring from Lithuania. He weighs 123 kilos. The Russian Nightmare, Nikita Koloff. His opponent's total combined weight, 467 pounds. First from Valdosta, Georgia, Tim Hughes. From Corpus Christi, Texas, Mike Maverick.
Well, fans, before this one gets underway, I don't think I've ever seen Sting as intense as he is. And when you talk about intensity, that man has got to be also positioned at the top of the list. He's almost at the top of the top 10. He is currently ranked number 2 in the entire world in the top 10 rankings. And Nikita Koloff in this handicap match. But as we said earlier, this past Sunday in Baltimore, I really don't think anything was settled conclusively between Nikita Koloff and Sting. Perhaps it will be settled this coming week. I know Tuesday, Stinger looking forward to seeing the great fans at the Great Western Forum in Los Angeles, and then the weekends in the Coliseum in Oakland on Friday night. Mike Maverick and Tim Hughes will act as a tag team. Koloff technically only has to pin one of the men to win the match. But he's in there with two young men that are very hungry and know that they can be noticed by all the promoters by being involved in a victory over a Koloff who's ranked so high in the world rankings. Quick tags, good strategy by Hughes and Maverick thus far, working on the arm of Nikita Koloff. Koloff indeed is the master of the Russian chain match. He can use that chain as a weapon at any time. We've seen him do just that, as he has it hanging in a neutral ring corner, ironically enough. Elbow by the intense man that weighed in at 123 kilos. Hip blocking Hughes out of the corner. Well, fans, we hope that you'll call the wrestling hotline today. We'll give you some information on the World Tag Team Title Tournament that will be starting here next week on TBS, as Koloff with one arm taking down Mike Maverick, exemplifying the tremendous upper body strength that that man possesses. Next week here on the broadcast, in addition to the Freebirds and the Hardliners in the World Tag Team Title Tournament, which should be a great matchup, the Yellow Dog will take on the Diamond Stud. Two more big hours for you here next Saturday. And Koloff taking Maverick to the steel. What a crowd on hand. The excitement really abounds when the Great American Bash Tour goes on the road. And as we've been talking. There you hear what the fans are saying. They know what they want to see. The most popular athlete, without a doubt, not only in WCW, but perhaps in professional sports, the Stinger and his tremendous throng of little Stingers. We know they'll have their faces painted, and they'll be a prominent display in the Stinger's home state of California this coming week. But remember, though, fans, Nikita Koloff will be there as well. And now Maverick and Hughes trying some double teams. They're showing some confidence here. These young men came to fight. And Koloff caught them both. Koloff just snuffed out the offense. He got them both with double sickles, and that's it.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner, the Russian Nightmare, Nikita Koloff.
I want you, Stan.
The intense rivalry that exists between Sting and Nikita Koloff has just begun. This awesome competitor from Lithuania, indeed on a collision course with a Stinger. These men involved in what could be a career-ending feud. And it could end this week in California. Fans, when we come back, the world television champion, Stunning Steve Austin, will be in action.
For one ball, introducing first, accompanied by Lady Blossom from Hollywood, California, weighing 253 pounds. He is the WCW World Television Champion, Stunning Steve Austin. And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent from Tampa, Florida, weighing 281 pounds, Jim Manning.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we certainly hope you'll be with us tomorrow. The main event's going to be an outstanding broadcast, and we'll be talking more about the Steiner situation and the vacated World Tag Team Championship. We'll talk more about the tournament tomorrow. We'll also have an update on the United States Heavyweight Championship belt, and we'll see the Yellow Dog take on Mr. Hughes in a bounty match, and we may just see the unmasking of the Yellow Dog tomorrow on the main event. Stunning Steve, the World Television Champion, who survived the Scapa match in Baltimore, but he is...
They give me some competition out here.
Currently ranked number 6 in the world. He's a current World Television Champion. A lot of long list of men headed by beautiful Bobby Eaton would love to have the opportunity to wrestle this man for the coveted WCW TV title. Wide base exhibited by Austin. Really distributing his legs or his weight. And well, there you see Theodore R. Long and Johnny B. Bad coming out here in the ring. I wonder if they're going to come... I don't know the reason for this. In any event, it looks like I'm going to have some company here. Johnny B. Bad and Theodore R. Long joining yours truly here at ringside as we watch Stunning Steve against a big 281-pounder. And gentlemen, I welcome you to ringside. It's a rather unscheduled, but...
Oh, hush, Jimmy, hush.
Oh, I had to talk. It's my job. What's the reason for this?
Well, let me say something, Jim Ross. The beautiful Johnny B. Bad, the fashion plate of World Championship Wrestling, and the Godfather. We're out here just to take a look at the World Television Champion. We think he's an outstanding athlete, and we'd just like to take a look at him. How about that? Johnny, what do you got to say about the World TV Champion, baby?
Oh, I think Stunning Steve is so big with them big old muscles and everything. I think he's the greatest television champion of all time. He's such a big stud.
Well, I guess, yeah. Stunning Steve working on the arm of Jim Manning.
You know, Teddy, I just love Lady Blossom's earring. I want to go inquire where she got those.
Well, let me say something to you right now, Johnny. Now, I don't mind you going over there talking to Lady Blossom, but now, you make sure you don't let her touch you now.
Oh, hush,
don't let her touch
hush.
You. Okay, baby.
You going to go look, talking about her earrings?
Yeah, he wants to go see her earrings. We might have to get some of them.
Well, yeah, maybe. Johnny B. Badd and Lady Blossom have a nice little conversation.
And here you can also see Jim Ross as Stunning Steve is not going to have any problem with this fella in the ring here today. The man is awesome. What a tough competitor. World television
stun
champion.
Stun gun. Stun gun right back in the ring. Austin got the 281-pounder up. He nailed him with a stun gun. While on the outside, Lady Blossom and Johnny B. Badd are talking earrings.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, the WCW World Television Champion, Stunning Steve Austin.
Stunning Steve, Lady Blossom not in the ring. I don't know if she even knows the match is over.
Uh-oh. Well, Stunning Steve.
Well, Stunning Steve taking a little exception. Lady Blossom has devoted a little bit of her attention to Johnny B. Badd. Let's look at the slow-mo. There you see the stun gun. Very impressive considering the man was 281 pounds. Great victory for Stunning Steve Austin. Johnny, I'm anxious. What did Stunning Steve have to say to you there? It looked like he was too happy.
Stunning Steve got all puffy. Teddy just seemed to get all puffy at me. I don't understand. I was talking to pretty Lady Blossom, and he just seemed to get all puffy. I can't understand. I was just inquiring about her beautiful earrings and her nails and the color of her lipstick. It was so pretty.
So I guess maybe you can patch that up, Teddy. Apparently, there's a little misunderstanding about the earrings.
No misunderstanding, Jim Ross. What it is, that Lady Blossom has some nice earrings on, and Johnny B. Badd likes them, and we might have to get some of them. You know what I mean?
Okay, well, thank you very much, gentlemen.
We're out of here.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, don't forget what a pair they are. Don't forget tomorrow's main event. It'll be the Yellow Dog in that big bounty match against the awesome Mr. Hughes, very controversial individual. And we know his background. We know all about him. And remember, right here next Saturday, we will start the World Tag Team Tournament, the Freebirds and the Hardliners, right here next Saturday night. For Gary Capetta and Paul E. Dangerously, we'll speak to you again on the main event.